right, what's up, guys? Hey, listen, Travis SmashweRx, you know the routine. All right, so here's the deal. We're gonna make this super fast, but not gonna get fancy. We're talking about ankle mobility. So, ankle mobility, this is a big deal because what happens is the 26 bones of the foot, we don't have to get fancy, 26 bones of the foot adapt to the terrain, right? Everything we do, about 17,000 steps a day, big deal, right? But there's a specific bone sitting in here. It's the talus and the tibia, the shin bone, and the fibula that run down the side make this little arch. And inside the arch is the talus, and it needs to be able, the two bones need to be able to glide back and forth, and in doing that, the talus needs to be able to tuck backwards to allow something called dorsiflexion. Now that's a big deal. So if you're having an issue with your squats, or you're having an issue running, or your ankles impinge, or you have all kinds of problems with your gait, even sleeping, plantar fasciitis, check that talus first. And I'm gonna show you three things to undo that limited dorsiflexion. So just to give you an idea what dorsiflexion is when you bring the toe up towards your shin. So I'm gonna show you two things. One is how to test your dorsiflexion. So we'll take this, oh, you can actually see it over there. Okay, so how to test your dorsiflexion is you go 5 inches from a wall, okay? I'm gonna pretend this is a wall. I'm gonna plant my heel on the ground. Here's how you check it. If you make it, you're good. If you don't make it, you're bad. You just take your foot and you drive it, or your knee rather, and you drive it all the way forward while maintaining the heel contact on the ground. If you can do that, you're good. If your foot comes up this way, not so good. Don't worry about the ring in the way, but this is a super fast video because I gotta bounce out of the house. So I'm gonna show you how to fix that talus. It's called the talar tuck first. And then how to regain some calf mobility, which is probably limiting all this this function of the foot because it's holding that foot in what's called plantar flexion, which is the other way around. Now, by the way, if you're taking your kettlebell and you're sitting in your class and you're putting your foot over here and you're doing this on a kettlebell, stop doing that. That's just garbage. There's a million better ways to do it than this. Stop doing that, all right? So I'm gonna show you a better way because it's time under tension, and that's a big deal. If you don't have time under tension, if you don't load that tissue for a long enough period of time, I don't care what research says, it's not gonna change. This tissue has to stay loaded for an entirely different amount of time than, let's say, the quad, because this tissue supports you, and that tendon, and this, the retinaculum in the front, the back, everything in here, the three muscles that come across that culminate the calf, plus that popliteus in here, even the knee function is all married and all related. If you don't get time under tension, this won't change ever. So the first thing we need to do, time under tension, is we take our foot, put it inside this band. Okay? This is an inch and a half band. You guys ask, inch and a half band, it's a rogue band. You're gonna put this right around where that talus is. Then you're gonna load that band. Now I'm gonna take my knee, I'm gonna drive my heel down into the ground, and I'm gonna keep that band loaded, so I'm gonna pull this up a little bit so you can see what I'm doing. I'm gonna keep that band loaded, and I'm gonna drive my knee out and forward while keeping my heel on the ground, and then I'm gonna stay like this 2 minutes. That's number one. Number two is courtesy of Kelly Starrett. Other people have done it before, but I may as well throw him a bone because he's the one that kind of pioneered a lot of this, is the bone saw. You're gonna take your foot, it's like some kind of weird thing on the bottom of my shoe. So you're gonna take your shin, and you're gonna bring it across your calf, and then you're gonna sit on it. That's it, that's all you've gotta do. Find that tender spot, and then just wiggle. This is the anywhere, anytime, doing the friggin' airport kind of thing. So, just to give you an idea of what I'm doing, because it's hard to see, I'm wearing sweatpants, it's cold. So, we're gonna raise this, so you can see what I'm doing. I'm taking my shin, and I'm bringing it across my calf, all right? Let's do this so you can actually see. But I'm bringing it. So I'm taking my shin from the other leg and I'm bringing it across my calf and I'm just gonna sit down on it and grind away, wiggle back and forth right on that calf. You can do this anywhere, it's just that easy. Now the last one is the important one. And this is the one that involves, see if I can pull this off without knocking the camera over. Can I? Oh, I did! Studley! So you wanna have your toes forward, you want enough weight that this isn't gonna change. So what I do is I take the weight, oh, that was heavier than I thought. Now, you just hang out like this. So I am forcing myself into dorsiflexion. My feet are straight, That's 135 on the bar. I'm not worried about my spine position right now. I'm more worried about loading this tissue. I'm gonna stay in this position, 2 minutes, call it a day. And that's it. Woo, heavy. Hey, listen, I'm Trev, SmashweRx, cleaning up your ankle mobility and your calves. I will check you guys out tomorrow.